Hello and welcome. In this video, we'll go through the setups related to banquet event orders and event reservations in general. We will use the demo data as a sample and go through the settings and how they affect event reservations. We'll start with the reservation types. We have a reservation type called events. Here, I'm going to go through what's related specifically to the event reservation. In the view section, we define how the reservation looks. We want to see quantities. We want to show the number of persons. We want to see the additional charges. We can use those, for example, for food and beverage. Of course, we want to see price and amounts, and we change the default matrix views for the availability to show us events, or basically the event rooms available. We define what comments we want to see live on the reservation card. We want the task schedule as well, and we want to use the CRM for the opportunities. We also want to see the main resource. When we book an event reservation, we are normally booking event rooms. So we want to see that in the reservation line and just specifically reserve a specific room. Also, you would set up the banquet events here. So make sure your category is on. You can define how the BEO is going to be issued. If it's just going to be one summary, or if you want a summary of the BEO per day. You can also define where you want to see the reservation comments, if you want to have them at the top of the agenda or at the bottom of the BEO. The caption for the agenda, and then if you want to see on the BEO the people responsible for each event category. These would be the main settings for the BEO view and the reservation type. Then you would have to set up the event categories. Event categories are the categories you want to see in the BEO. Normally, this would be food and beverage, the AV, and the room laptops. You might have sections in the BEO view where you want to kind of keep track of the charges related to each category. So we define which sections in the BEO we want, or the categories in BEO. Here, I have set up the AV. The room rental, there you could of course have a number of categories. Then you define the view sequence in which order they will be shown on the BEO. You can define if you want to see date and times also on the BEO. You can set up a filter on the related charges, for example, for food and beverage. You might want to filter that you only allow food and beverage categories of products. This is just an option if you want to limit or restrict what kind of items can be assigned to these charges. These are all BEO related settings. If you want to see the activity comments as part of the BEO for this category, if it's going to be a part of the agenda or not, we want a subtotal for the charges in this category. If we want to have an extra line after we should view the category, then this is an important setting, the default charges category. Basically, in an activity reservation, you have one line for the activity itself. Normally, that might be the room rental, for example. But then you have charges associated to that activity. In this case, when I enter room rental, I don't want the charges as event category room rental, but I rather want the charges related to that activity line to be of the type food and beverage category. We'll see this better when we show the BEO. Then you define the notification days. This is where you set up notifications to be sent to responsible persons when there's a change in the reservation on some line that belongs to this particular event category. You can define that only up to 10 days or 15 days or however long it is before the event starts, you want to start to notify people of changes. So basically, while you're entering the reservation at the beginning, you don't want to be constantly issuing notifications for every change taking place. You just want it after a certain time. Then you have the responsibility setup. So for each event category, you can assign what people, either employees or contacts, are responsible for that particular event category. For example, the F&D manager or the chef might be responsible for the food and beverage, and you might have an electrician responsible for the AV, and so forth. As I said, it could be either an internal contact or an external contact here. When a person is assigned responsibility for a specific event category, they would be notified if there are changes to the event reservation. This would be the default setup. Who are responsible? Of course, per reservation. You can also change the responsibility, so you might have different responsibilities for a specific reservation. But here, you can define the defaults. Then you have something quite commonly used for event reservations. That is the deposit policy. I've set up here one policy of 50% upfront. You assign a deposit policy on the reservation, and then you can define that either after the confirmation date or before the reservation date, an X number of days, you can then require a specific, either fixed deposit or a percentage of the total amount. Then we would start to track outstanding deposits, and you can also issue invoices specifically for the deposit part. Then, also related to event workings, you would set up the statuses. For example, on the confirm status. If we take a look at that, we have here in the advanced section, for example, if we are issuing a deposit schedule automatically when we confirm our reservation, or also the email handling. We're going to use BEOs for that. If we're using BEOs, then we want the confirm status to update the BEO version. So when you confirm a reservation and when you modify and reconfirm, you want the BEO version to be updated. You can also choose whether you also want to update it and notify the responsible person as well. So you can either add this confirm status to setup, or you can create specific statuses just to handle event reservations. Also related to events would be the use of package offers. And in the demo data, we have a sample here. 3-course dinner or dinner. So you can create a food and beverage package or a package that consists of both activities or room rental and food and beverage. You can have a fixed price. For example, on this setup, you can quote, you can charge or invoice the product upfront or afterwards, but you can then separate the consumption using the allowances in the package. So, when you create a reservation for an event, you might be invoicing and charging the event charges either afterwards or before the event. But then the consumption is tracked on the POS as an allowance, so you get correct consumption on the ingredients of the package. In this case, the coffee cake and related products. Now, these would be the settings to define prior to using the event reservations and BEOs in else activity. Thank you very much.